Finally, users have direct access to organizational document templates in Office 365 from anywhere, especially users working from home, and it is very quick to set up. Now, this is all thanks to the Content Delivery Network, or CDN, and this is part of your SharePoint Online subscription. CDN was released through Azure, I think around about end of 2017. And what it does, it just gives your users access to images and other sort of web assets, JavaScript, Ajax, CSS stuff. And it improves the speed to download the content, and it also lowered latency, rather than just placing them in a library somewhere. And to the point that in 2020, they used CDN to cache SharePoint Online videos and improve the playback and the reliability as you watch them. Now you can use CDN to provide your users with Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint templates, which they can access from the Office desktop, Office Online, even from the mobile apps, which will be improved in the future. So how does it work? Well, you store your image and Office template assets in origins. And an origin can be a SharePoint library, it can even be a folder. And you can place these into any type of SharePoint site you like, as long as it's not connected to an Office 365 group, because that kind of complicates it. You can have up to 30 different origins for all your company asset needs. And then you connect those origins to the content delivery network, and then the CDN uploads those assets as cached static assets, so they're faster to download to the user, and again, reduces latency. So we can complete this task in less than 5 minutes. And you need at least one SharePoint site, at least one library, or as many as you need for your origins. Now, any user or content manager can set up the origins and upload the templates and do that in minutes. But to enable it in CDN, this is done through PowerShell and requires Office admin rights and about 2 or 3 minutes of their time. So I'm going to show you the process. I'm going to upload Word and Excel and PowerPoint templates to a library, and you're going to see me accessing those directly from the desktop, the Office Online, and the mobile apps as well. I'm even going to show you with image assets how we can share them in the same way. And I'll use nothing more than a news page and show you how I can grab the corporate images and use them into news web pages and other sort of means. So this is the Microsoft Word desktop app before the origins are added to CDN. And if I click new, you can see I have the office and personal tabs for templates. But when this is complete, there will be a new one labeled with my Office 365 tenancy. So you can create a SharePoint site, add a library first. I'm going to use the default SharePoint site I have. And I have a library ready and waiting called Office Templates. The last stage for me as the user is to upload the template files. So unlike content types that you add to a library new button, where you can add any sort of files you like, these need to be specifically Office template file types, such as DOTX for Word, XLTX for Excel, and POTX for PowerPoint. Now it's the admin's turn, so I will run PowerShell as administrator. All the code needed is in the description below. You just need to add the URL paths for your origins and sites. So first, I'll make sure that I have Microsoft Online SharePoint PowerShell module installed, which is a pretty straightforward copy and paste of the code in the description. Next, I'll connect to the SharePoint Online service. So I just need to enter between the two quotes the URL of my SharePoint admin. Now, this is typically your tenancy name, -admin.sharepoint.com. Enter username and password as normal. Copy and paste the Office template library script line into PowerShell. And between the quotes after the library URL, you want the URL to your library and you can copy that from the address bar. Make sure you include the folder name if your origin is to point to a folder. The CDN type can be private if you only want Office 365 users to access it, or public, which provides anonymous access to the templates. Press enter and confirm with a Y that you want to proceed. Now, if you're activating CDN for the first time, you may need to say yes to two confirmations. I'm going to repeat this for an asset library where I've got some company branding images and other logos. And the PowerShell code is the same principle as before, except the org asset type this time will be image document library. And that's it. The process is complete. Time to wait for CDN to complete its jobs.
24 hours later.
Right, so if I open up Microsoft Word, click the new tab here, and you can now see I've got this Data Academy tab. And within that is my A4 headed template. Fantastic. Give that a quick click, and it should actually opens up faster than normal because that's got quite a fair bit of graphic in that header. Try Excel. New, there we go, Data Academy, and that should have my quote template in there. Brilliant. And we're going to try PowerPoint, new Data Academy, and once again there it is. Brilliant. Now, not only have I got them in the desktop apps, but if I go to online and launch to the dashboard of any of those apps, you can see I've got an Office templates folder, and there I've got my templates there as well, which is fantastic. Now, what about Office Mobile? Well, at the moment, we don't have that same sort of launching to, directly to the templates, but I can go to the sites where they're placed. I can open the library and I can launch the template from there. And that's going to be just as good until the features are fitted to the mobile app. And just to show that that is the Word document, it's not just a white piece of paper. If I convert that to PDF, there it is. It's the same Word document. Fantastic. The last thing I wanted to do is show you how this works with those image assets that I put into the assets library. So if I create a brand new post here and just add a new image to the header, and you can see there's a your organization location now, and in there's the site assets, and there they are. There's all the company logo images that I put into there. And that's it. So it's very quick and easy now to even work with corporate branding. Now, the good news is you have seen that this takes less than 5 minutes to do. The bad news is the content delivery network service can take anything from 2 to 24 hours to complete its magic before those templates are available to the users. Now, when I did this, the first origin took 18 hours. I had to wait. But the additional origins that I've been plugging in have taken no more than a maximum of an hour to before they appear. So I think the kicking in of the CDN into life is the biggest hurdle, not literally kicking in the CDN. That won't do any good at all. That would probably do damage. Microsoft have also announced that CDN only makes sense, as they say it, in a SharePoint Online context. So I think there's a hint or way of saying don't use it with SharePoint Server. And also, as of when this video went out, which is about August 2021, the CDN service is not available to the US government or tenancies residing in China or Germany. I don't know if that also affects our UK government here or our Ministry of Defence, because they have their own private sort of connections, their own sort of private tenancies, and therefore probably isn't been plugged out to those, and it's for those reasons. Please subscribe to my channel so I can keep you posted with offerings of Office 365 tips and tricks. You can find me on social networks, and you can post me your own questions for me to answer. Also, search for Data Academy on YouTube. It's a brand new channel. It will be providing 15-20 minute lessons on the Power platform. So we really want to help skill you up and put power into your own hands with Office 365. Stay safe and have fun.